Good morning, everybody. Steve and I are out here at our homemade vernal pool, which I think Steve made around 4 or 5 years ago. And you can see there's something very special in the middle of this frame. And if you guessed wood frog eggs, you are right. So they finally found this pool. They have really high site affinity, which means wherever they're born, they usually go back to continue the breeding cycles. But about 15 to 20% is what we read will leave. And then now these, most of them will stay here in this pool. So the 15 to 20% that ventured out into the world, some of them found this pool, and then around 80% or so will come back. And now that's of course assuming those live. Tadpoles are a very vulnerable stage, and there's a lot of predaceous diving beetles in here which love tadpoles. So it's going to be interesting to observe, but we have been so thrilled to be up there at our house and hear the quacking coming from this pool, indicating the wood frogs. They moved right away in one of those first warm rains, along with chorus frogs, into here. And there's several masses. So right there, there's 1, 2, 3. And then there's some right over here on this edge. And there's a couple more in the middle. I'm not gonna be able to show you in this lighting, but we're supposed to get some really good rain in about 2 days, which is perfect because the pool needs it. So this is encouragement to you. If you live close to any type of area that provides the upland habitat that these frogs need, so for wood frogs, it's a pretty good forest cover. For chorus frogs, grasslands. And you live next to that and you create a vernal pool, you are going to have success. And some of it will require patience. We had frogs the first year, but not wood frogs. So like I said again, 4 or 5 years and they found it. And Steven, how does that make us feel?
Awesome, you can do it too.
Woohoo! All right, do the frog dance, everybody.